Hi and welcome. In this video, we're going to show you a dynamic way of entering a financial year from a date. So you just change one button and it changes to March financial year, April, whichever month of the year you want. So let's go and format the cell first. Control 1. Let's make it as a date. Bottom value. Click OK. Let's make a list of random dates equals random. Ran between. We want a date. We want it from year 2000, January, 1st of January, close brackets, comma, open brackets, the next date. We want it till today, 2023, stroke 5, stroke 24, 24th of May, close brackets. This is still showing, so close brackets again. See here. Enter. Control L to make it into a list, because then the list keeps its formatting when you're dragging it down. You'll see what I mean now. Click OK. Let's drag this down. Let's create about 50 random dates. Okay, they are random dates. Now we need to take the formula out, because otherwise when you put our formula for the financial year, it's not going to work out right because this keeps changing. But another thing I just want to make you aware of when you're using what's so useful about using tables, you must always name your columns small caps for database, snake case, always, no matter what. You'll understand if you're watching all the videos why I say that. Sometimes, as we say so often, you've got to just have blind faith when you're learning database and things like that, and understand later. Let's just move the date slightly this way so we can see it. Alright, so now we want to get the formula for the financial year from the date. So let's quickly take this formula out, select the whole column, control C for copy, control V for paste, choose values. There are formulas out of every cell. Now let's go and enter the formula for the financial year. So first thing, sometimes the formulas don't work if your formatting is not right, so it's best to format it as a number. So let's format it as a number, so it is already in a format number. We choose equals if, double click. So we want to say if the month of the date. Now if I didn't change this column name, this column would have said another, this formula would have shown another name. I'll show you now what I mean. So if the month of date, the date is greater than 2, then the year of the date plus 1, else year of the date, just the year of the date, close brackets, enter. It's working perfectly. Drag it down. So now you can see if it's March, it must move on one, because it's year ending February, so you can see all the dates are right. So now let me show you what I mean by if you don't name your columns right. Let's just name this column small caps amount. Number, let's check this year financial year, sorry. Alright, small cap, snake case, naming convention, important. So now, this is for February, so now if we change this, watch what happens to this formula. It says date now. What if I change this to gibberish? Now this formula changes to gibberish. So that's why naming your column headers, in the making everything into a table and then naming it, you know, with proper names, makes your formulas all neat and the thing that makes sense. So let's go and change that back to date. So now it's all nice. Look how nice it is. Date, it says date, and you can understand the formula. So the one problem we've got now, it says 2. We wanted rather to say financial year. So let's go and make another column here, insert. Let's call this financial year. So let's go and put 2 over here. You'll see what I'm meaning now. Let's create a named range from this. So let's highlight both cells, formulas, create from selection, left row, click OK. So now we've got our, this one's named now financial year. Now I can change my formula. So I can replace this. So it says financial year. So I just click this, click in here, click enter. copy it down. How's that for a nice formula? If month date is greater than financial year, then make it like that. So now, if your financial year is March, you just click March and it adjusts. If you watch this column here, you'll see it. This should change to 16. So if I click 3, changes to 16. It's dynamic. So let's take an April one. Let's find it, see if we can. So if May ending is May, this one should change to 15. So let's go and click this 5. So the May should be 15. Let's go and find the May one. There it's 15. So now you've got a dynamic financial year end, which you can change at a click of a button. And you see, remember naming convention, small caps, snake case, columns that make, column headers that make sense. So when you do your formulas, it hasn't got cell references, it's got nice writing. Anybody who reads your file can see month, date, financial year. So this is always important when you're doing database in Excel as well. And these in the brackets are called parameters. And then what you enter into the parameters are called arguments. Now, you won't understand this now, but this helps you hugely later on when you're working with databases to know what parameters are in functions and things like that. So remember in the brackets, you got parameters that must be entered, and whatever you enter in the parameter is called an argument. So I think that's going to do it for this video. If you like what you see, please click the like button below. Subscribe to receive future videos that I create. Feel free to make comments in the comment section below, and thank you for watching.